はい、
はい、
ごめんなさい、ごめんなさい、ごめんなさい、成為我們的這個遊戲的那個冠軍啦。
OK, thank you very much.
So, 我看你好像對一些Continental Car 都很熟悉下喔。
Yes, I know about Japanese and also Continental Car. So it's very important to actually stable the car, okay, for our road user in Malaysia as well, yeah.
Okay. So, 我呢度有幾個問題想問下你咁樣。Okay. So, 第一個問題係，好似我哋嘅嗰個遊戲嗰度咁樣講啦，我咁樣嘅問題。Okay. 你點解你會知呢個3-1-1.5係原裝係冇 anti-lock bar 嘅咧
？Okay. Basically, BMW there is a few specs, and I think for the lower range like the 318, due to the price and the specification, and due to the power which is not so powerful.I think the manufacturer did not include the anti-roll bar into the 318. But if you look at the other models like 320 and the higher specs, there is bigger and thicker anti-roll bar in place for all the BMW cars actually. Yeah.
Okay, 好，呢個真係好好一個知識，我哋真係對呢啲BM 嘅車都係。睇得出真係好熟悉下。OK， 我哋繼續嚟第二個問題啦。第二個問題係你知道嘛？F30 同 M3 有咩分別咧
？OK， if you compare with the BMW F30 and a M3 or an M5, the specification of the suspension, power, the anti-roll bar thickness, it's very different.So because of the power of the car, the manufacturer need to stabilize the car very thoroughly. So this is, I think, the specification of each manufacturer. And especially for BMW, it's a performance car. So you really need to stabilize the car, especially for high speed.
Okay, 是的，对的。对于这个普通版的这个F30, 它前面的 anti-roll bar 是 25mm 的，后面是 13mm 的。對於呢個 M3 版本嘅話咧，佢係 Sport 版，所以佢嘅anti-lock bar 前面 anti-lock bar 同後邊嘅 anti-lock bar 會更加會大 size 少少，即係講會比較大 mm 少少大過嗰個普通版本咯，嗬。OK， 所以我哋嚟到第三個問題啦。OK， 第三個問題想問下你，你覺得呢個3-1-1.5cc 係點講？係冇 anti-lock bar 噶嘛？所以佢需要去。Add on 一個 anti-roll bar 俾佢冇？你覺得需要冇
？Okay, for those who have actually purchased a 318, and if they found out that it's without an anti-roll bar, it's not a problem because you have already paid and you have already owned the 318. So the only thing is to find a reliable, like say for ultra racing, since you have already made the bar, just add on, and then you will make a lot of difference. So that's the most important. It's like also MyV.The MyV, the 1.5 SE, there's no anti-roll bar at the back, so you just need to add on. It's a fixed, given opportunity for you to add on. So for those car lovers, they will really enjoy it. But the most important part is the stability of the car. You will be able to feel it.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. So 你我睇到你今日都係有揸同BM 嚟 on bar 喎。
啱。啱。F30。
都係 F30 嚟嘅，
所以
你覺得 OK？ 講一講佢嘅感受啦，我哋講一講佢嘅感受啦。你都對Ultra Racing都幾熟悉嘅，你對 BM 都幾熟悉下。所以你覺得呢個Ultra Racing佢嘅好處喺邊度嘅
？I think the benefit of putting the anti-roll bar is to actually stabilize the car. One, two is that you feel that when you brake, okay, the car tend to stop.Shorter instead of longer, and third of all is something strange when you put in the bar, your cabin noise tend to reduce, so it's a little bit more silent in the cabin bar. So I think this is very very important, and the price that you're paying is very low. I think for a lot of drivers, this is a must for them to put in. Yeah, and especially for F30, when you're going for high speed, what you need is stability.I think that's very very important. Yep.
Okay, okay. Thank you, thank you, thank you. 你今日嘅花呢個時間過嚟我哋呢度安呢個bar咯，誒咁啊 ，thank you 你接受我哋個訪問咯。Okay,
sure. thank you.
Okay, 頭先大家都有睇到咯。Okay, 呢個訪問呢個 interview。Okay, 大家都知道 F30 1.5 原廠嚟係冇 anti-roll bar 嘅。Okay, 系摸后边嘅 Indy Loba 嘅。不过唔使担心，唔使讲担心我去边度去揾呢个 Indy Loba 啊，或者系咩咁样，唔使担心嘅。OK， 因为我出你先，有出俾呢一台车。OK， 前面有7 mm， OK， 后边16 mm 嘅。OK， 大家今日嘅 video 就到此为止。OK， 我哋下一个 video 再见，拜拜。